Previously on The Bill.
No. Becky's in hospital, and you not giving me a name makes that person more of a suspect.
There's no way Jimmy would hurt Miss James.
Jimmy Ryan.
Stop lying, Jimmy.
I don't have nothing to say to you.
Oh, you're awake.
So are you, finally.
Sorry, was I snoring?
The drool that was getting to me. Have you been here all night?
Yeah, I wanted to see you when you woke up.
Something happened. Did you get the guy that did this to me?
Yeah, we did. His name's Marcus Bentley. Ring any bells?
No, should it?
Marcus Bentley claims somebody paid him to break into your house. He said he was approached and offered money to steal your laptop.
I mean, who would? It must be a lie.
We'll know more after we interview him in detail. Now, can you think of anything important or valuable that's on it?
A few work assessments. My great unfinished novel. Mate, I'm an art teacher, not a secret agent.
So, according to Marcus Bentley, a couple of nights ago at approximately 8:45, he was approached by an as-yet-unknown man in the car park of the Cat and Sparrow pub on Gunner Street. Less than 2 hours later, Becky James arrives home early. They struggle, she ends up unconscious.
So what was in it for Marcus?
£500, apparently. Half up front, half after, all cash.
Was there a handover?
No, a drop-off, or so he says.
Did they say where or when?
Around 11:30 the same night, Marcus Bentley claims he left the laptop underneath the bin in Shadwell Street. He also claims there was a blue rucksack inside containing £250.
Millie, can you head over to Shadwell Street, get all the CCTV coverage of the area in the last 48 hours?
What about the Cat and Sparrow car park?
Already checked that. There is no CCTV there.
But this isn't the only break-in to involve Becky James in the last 24 hours.
No, Kim Patterson and Jimmy Ryan broke into a classroom about 12:30 last night, just a few hours after her attack.
Both are students at Deansgate Comprehensive. Marcus was excluded from Deansgate 7 years ago for theft.
Nate, you're due at Deansgate anyway. Might be worth having a chat with Kim and Jimmy, see if there is any sort of connection.
Marcus Bentley. He was difficult. Professional thief by the time he was 14. Exclusion was our only option after he'd broken into the staff room for the third time in less than a year.
Have you seen him around school recently? Maybe talking to Kim or Jimmy?
No, neither of them would have been here at the time Marcus was excluded.
Well, either way, I'd like to have a word with him, if they're around.
We haven't seen Jimmy yet. As for Kim, well, we're not sure whether she'll be back at all. After what happened yesterday, her father's taken her out of school indefinitely. Kim was suspended about 4 years ago for being disruptive, but her mum had died a couple of years before, so it was understandable. But she's settled down, she's got through it. Is something going on? With Kim, I mean?
No, it's just routine stuff.
So this is the bin on Shadwell Street at 11:37 two nights ago.
That's Marcus Bentley.
This is Marcus doing his bit to keep it entirely.
Okay, so far so good. This seems to confirm Bentley's version of events. What next?
A couple of minutes later, another car comes along.
All right.
Unfortunately, we never get a good look at the driver. But whatever Marcus left under there is now gone.
Well, I can't make out that registration, can you?
No, I've said it's technical. They're going to enhance the image not for too long.
Okay, great. Will you run the PNC check?
Sure.
Thanks.
Dad's not here. Don't you need an appropriate adult or something?
Your dad asked us to let you know Becky's progress.
Is she better?
She's doing okay. She should be discharged later today. Is it good? Are these yours?
No, those are my mum's. This is her room, was her room. She's dead. Cancer 6 years ago.
Sorry.
Why? It's not your fault. It was God's. At least that's what Dad says. He keeps this room just like it was when she was alive, to remember her by.
Is she mum?
Her name was Sarah.
You take after her?
I know.
You like art, don't you, Kim? Is that why you're in the school the other night? To do some painting?
That was Jimmy. I wasn't feeling very creative.
Right. So what were you doing for 5 hours?
You know, just hanging out.
In Becky James's classroom?
Yeah, so? This is about what happened to Miss James, isn't it?
What makes you think that?
Because I'm not a complete idiot.
No, you're not that. Thing is, Kim, what happened to Becky wasn't an accident. A professional thief was paid to break into her flat. Have you seen this guy before? His name's Marcus Bentley. He went to Deansgate about 7 years ago. He was paid £500 to steal Becky's laptop.
Her computer, why? What's this got to do with me?
Did anyone ask you to break into the school the other night?
No.
Then what were you doing there?
It's where I feel safe. It's supposed to be a sanctuary.
That room specifically?
Why are you asking me these questions? I would never do anything to hurt her. I loved Becky. She left us, not the other way around.
What do you mean she left you?
She and my dad had a thing. It ended about 6 months ago, but it was nice having her around. While it lasted.
Nate, it's Joe. We've got a lead. Do you want to come back to the Nick?
Okay, I'm on my way, Joe. Kim, thank you. What have we got?
Just watching our suspect take delivery of the laptop.
What about the PNC check?
Part of the press, Mark. We've got a blue 2008 Land Rover Range Rover. Registration LC58FUD. No form, nothing on the owner. He's a doctor, lives locally.
Hang on, this car's registered to Russell Patterson. It's Kim's dad.
You said Russell Patterson had a relationship with Becky James.
That's what Kim said. Ended 6 months ago.
Why on earth would Becky's ex go to all this trouble to get hold of her laptop?
And if there was something incriminating on there, he's waited a long time to do something about it.
Right, well, let's get Patterson in. Get Marcus Bentley to video ID him.
Marcus Bentley would ID the Pope if he thought he'd get his letter to the judge. Dr. Patterson has no motive, no priors, and we have no hard evidence. In fact, all we have is a grainy CCTV shot of his car. Joe, take a look at his finances. There must be some record if he had to get his hands on 500 quid in cash.
Gov.
I think it's time we spoke to Becky James.
Gov.
Oh. Russell, what's he got to do with any of this?
We have reason to believe he might be behind it.
Or at least involved. You had a relationship with Dr. Patterson.
How did you know about that?
Kim told me.
She told you that?
Was it meant to be a secret?
No, well, relationships between teachers and their students' parents are not exactly encouraged, especially when they meet at parent-teacher night.
How did it end?
Is it really any of your business?
It is if Dr. Patterson paid a career thief £500 to steal a laptop from you.
What happened with Patterson?
I ended it, that's all. It wasn't working out. Look, Russell didn't even understand. I didn't give him a reason. I just ended it. Withdrew from the situation.
What situation?
The relationship. The whole thing. He's a widower. There's so much sorrow in that home. I couldn't stay. Russell was angry. I guess hurt, I suppose. He didn't understand. But that's it.
And nothing's happened since?
I haven't spoken to him in 6 months.
What about his daughter, Kim? What's your relationship like with her?
No different than any of my other students.
She and Jimmy Ryan broke into your classroom hours after you were attacked.
Kim and Jimmy.
Is it possible that Dr. Patterson wanted something else of yours? Something from that classroom? And sent his daughter Kim to get it?
Kim would never. She's a total innocent. Besides, Russell is a governor. He has total access.
How long has Dr. Patterson been a governor at Deansgate?
I don't know, a while, before Kim started.
Okay. I'll see you back at the Nick. There's something you want to check out.
You okay?
I think I'm allowed to go home now.
Have you got somewhere to stay? I can give you a lift if you want.
Can you take me home?
Home? You sure you're ready?
Well, I'm gonna have to face up to it sooner or later. That's where I went as soon as he came in.
Are you sure you want to be here? You don't have to rush this.
I'll survive.
And there's nothing you can think of that could have been on that laptop?
No. Unless somebody put something there that, without me ever seeing or knowing about it. Nice to see Marston's finally been inspired to tidy up. Shouldn't you be getting back?
Yeah. Listen, do you mind if we check your email accounts?
Work or personal?
Both. Indulge me. You know, you don't have to stay here. You got nothing to prove. You shouldn't stay here alone.
It's all right. I'll be fine.
One thing that's been niggling me is how Russell Patterson knew Marcus's name. Not only his name, but enough about him to approach him with an offer. Marcus Bentley was excluded from Deansgate 7 years ago for being a practice thief. I've done some digging. And Dr. Patterson was a governor at that time. He could have been involved in the decision to exclude Marcus. Patterson would have known Marcus's name and what he was capable of.
So he would have approached Marcus with a certain degree of confidence?
Exactly.
Without evidence, it's a long shot.
Well, my speciality.
Okay, how about this then? 2 nights ago, Russell Patterson made 2 separate cash withdrawals from 2 separate bank accounts, all within an hour of each other.
Let me guess, the total sum of the 2 withdrawals was £500?
Bingo. But I don't think he planned it, though, because he used his own car and he made no attempt to cover up the cash trail.
He didn't think he'd get caught.
Come in, Nate.
It doesn't make any sense. Why doesn't Becky James have any idea what this is about? I mean, it's her laptop.
Well, maybe she never got the chance to find out.
What do you mean, Nate?
Well, Becky joked that somebody might have put something on a computer without her knowing about it. Something incriminating or dangerous. Maybe there was something on the computer that Russell knew about, but she didn't. I don't know, maybe he sent her an email, then regretted it.
Yeah, but to go to such lengths to get it back.
Do you have her email address?
Both. Work and personal.
Okay. I want everything that was cashed over the last 72 hours. And I think it's time we had a chat with Russell Patterson.
Oh, well, that's interesting. Because Dr. Patterson wants to talk to us. Apparently his daughter Kim's gone missing.
How are we going to play this?
By ear. We're here to interview a man who's concerned about his daughter's welfare. As for the rest, let's just see what he's got to say for himself.
This is the second time in 48 hours Kim Patterson's run away. Something's not right. How long has she been missing?
Well, I don't know exactly. I've been out. I had some patients to see. I got back about an hour ago and she wasn't here.
What makes you think she's run away?
She should have been here.
Maybe she just popped out.
No, you don't understand. She'd taken a bag, some clothes and some money. She's gone. Now, look, you've got to help me find her.
We will, Dr. Patterson. I'm sure she's going to be fine.
Is there any particular reason why she might have run away? Why now?
She's been troubled recently. Become more distant from me. I don't know why.
Is there any way you can think of that she might have gone? Does she have any family? Somewhere she goes in times of crisis?
The only family is her grandmother in Derby. I gave her a call. She hasn't heard from her.
Well, what about friends? You know, somebody at school? Somebody she could confide in?
Only the guy from last night.
Jimmy Ryan?
Yeah. You know, maybe he put her up to this.
Excuse me.
Okay, Nate, we'll go and check with Jimmy. Meanwhile, I'll get uniform over here to search for any clues that might help us find her.
What can I do?
If you come to the station with us, just got a few more questions for you.
Jimmy! Miss Rogers told me you're back. Shouldn't you be in class?
Shouldn't you be out catching criminals?
So that's it, is it? Giving up on school?
Whatever.
Jimmy! Looking for Kim. You heard from her.
She's at home, ain't she?
No. My dad's worried about her. So are we.
Maybe she just needs some time on her own.
Hey, come on, Jimmy. You're a mate of hers. If you know anything...
Look, I don't, all right? But if I did, I wouldn't tell you. She just needs everyone to back off. Stop interfering in her life. Her dad, you, Miss James.
Becky, what's she done?
I don't know what her problem is. She hasn't been able to leave Kim alone the past few months. Always calling her off for private chats and doing Kim's head in.
Do you know what about?
No. Kim doesn't want to talk about it. And I don't push it. Sometimes people just need some space, yeah?
Okay, yeah. Maybe you're right. Listen, Jimmy, this is important. If you hear from Kim, you let me know, yeah?
Dr. Patterson in the soft interview room for the time being.
Did the subject of Becky James come up at all?
No, not yet.
Right. Do we have people out looking for the girl?
Yeah, description's been circulated. Uniform are searching the house. They're going to keep their eyes open for any stray laptops.
Right. Any luck?
No.
Well, it seems unlikely that this girl's disappearance is coincidental. Something spooked her.
Yeah, that might have been me. I may have put too much pressure on her this morning.
Mom, we just found Kim Patterson's mobile in her bedroom.
Well, if she was going to run away, wouldn't she take her phone with her?
Well, maybe she didn't want to be contacted.
Well, people have been trying to contact her.
Hello.
Right, there's been 7 missed calls this morning, all after 10 o'clock. 3 from her dad, 2 from us here at the station, and 2 from this unknown number, both in the last hour.
That's Becky's home number.
Becky James? Why would she be ringing Kim Patterson?
Well, that was Joe. There's something we need to see in Becky's email account.
So, this is Becky James' personal email account.
Well, there's nothing from Russell Patterson.
If he stole the laptop because of a potentially dangerous email, he would have deleted it straight away.
See, there's nothing in her deleted items either, but this was sent from a service provider, and this was deleted from her email account yesterday at 12:30.
Dear Becky, I've just had another big fight with Dad. I think Mum would want me to talk to your friend, Peter Graves. Will you come with me? Please don't call. I'm going to leave now. See you at school tomorrow, Kim.
Is that it?
That's it.
Why would Patterson be so desperate to delete this? It doesn't seem to mean anything.
Not to us. Take this to Becky James. Find out what it means to her.
Go.
Sent this to me. I didn't know.
You weren't supposed to. Russell must have somehow seen the email Kim sent and did everything he can to make sure it doesn't get to you.
The only way to do that was to delete it from your email account. That's why he needed your laptop.
The question is why? Why was Russell Patterson so afraid of you seeing this? What's Kim telling you in this email?
Maybe that she was ready to talk.
About what?
I can't be sure. I need to speak to Kim first, do you understand? Can you bring her to me. Can you do that?
Kim's disappeared.
She's what?
She's run away. According to Russell, she packed her bags and left.
Are you sure?
Is there something going on in that house? After everything that's happened, I can't believe you're protecting him.
I'm not protecting him. I'm protecting her.
Who's Peter Graves?
He's a psychiatrist. I told Kim that he was a friend, someone she could talk to about anything. Peter specializes in child psychiatry for victims of sexual abuse.
What happened? What did you see that made you suspect?
You mean, did I ever see him touch her?
Mm-hmm.
No. It was a feeling. Do you understand? One night, I went over there on a whim, wanted some company. Russell was surprised to see me, but then went off, made some drinks. I went to Sarah's room. That's Russell's late wife. Kim was in there. She'd been crying. Just a little bit, enough to notice. I asked her what was wrong. She just smiled and said everything was fine now that I was back. It wasn't until later, you know, when you look back on things, that it all seemed to fall into place. The sadness, the dependency that Russell has on her, the way he's so protective and yet so familiar at the same time.
Why didn't you talk to anyone about this? Go to someone.
Who? The police? With what? My suspicions. I did what I could. I told our deputy head.
Tina Rogers?
She's in charge of pastoral care. Tina then spoke to Kim, who insisted that everything was fine at home. It was a dead end. I started to wonder if I got things terribly wrong. Kim was so adamant.
So what changed?
I just told her that I had a friend, a psychiatrist, that she could talk to if she wanted.
This is the Peter Graves mentioned in the email.
If Russell had read Kim's email, he would know exactly what it meant for him.
Becky, why didn't you tell us any of this earlier?
How could I? I didn't know about the email. Didn't know Kim was ready to talk. Before I'd read this, I wasn't even sure if I was right about any of it. Nate, I wasn't there for her when she needed me, and now she's disappeared.
It's okay. We'll find her.
She suspected that Russell Patterson was abusing his daughter.
Yes, Gov. She did what she could. She sent it up to her deputy head.
And nothing happened?
Well, it's not as simple as that. Unless there's any evidence, or the child, unless Kim acknowledges that some form of abuse is taking place, then there's very few options on how to proceed. There's no other family to consult. Becky never actually saw anything that qualifies as overt abuse. You're damned if you do and you're damned if you don't.
What do we do? I mean, after all we have is a terrible suspicion. Rumour from third hand.
Well, it's time to turn up the heat on Russell Patterson. Arrest him on conspiracy to commit burglary. And speak to Tina Rogers, confirm Becky James' story, but be discreet.
Go.
Any sign of Kim?
Barton Street are lending a hand, but there haven't been any sightings so far.
I told Kim that Becky was in hospital because somebody wanted to steal her laptop. She must have realised her father was responsible.
Oh, poor kid, she must be a mess.
Have you found her? What's happening? I mean, no one will tell me anything.
I'm afraid we don't have any idea where Kim is, Mr. Patterson. We were hoping you might be able to shed some light on the subject.
Russell Patterson, I'm arresting you on suspicion of conspiracy to commit burglary. You don't have to say anything, but it may harm your defense if you do not mention when questioned.
I came here because my daughter's missing, and now you're arresting me?
Anything you do say may be given in evidence. Do you understand?
Obviously, if Kim's missing, I want to do everything I can to help with your investigation. But you must understand there are some aspects of student confidentiality that I just can't break.
A while ago, you spoke to Kim Patterson at Becky James' request.
Is this about Kim's father? You're investigating Russell Patterson.
Why'd you say that?
Because if you've spoken to Becky, and now you're here asking questions about Kim, we all know Becky's suspicions about the underlying reasons for Kim's behaviour.
Do you share those suspicions?
When I spoke to Kim, she flatly denied any problems at home. She was very adamant about it. It's a very difficult situation, you understand? Kim's been fixated on the loss of a mother for years. None of this was helped by Becky coming in as a mother figure, only to disappear again. Becky's got good instinct, but unless Kim herself says something, our hands are tied. I hope you find her.
Kim seems to be on a different wavelength to the other kids at school.
She's found it hard to fit in, isolated herself completely.
No, not completely. I'm going to need to speak to Jimmy. Is he around?
I'm afraid he's gone again. Sorry.
Don't be. Chances are that means they're going to be together. Thank you.
I've never been in a pub called the Cat and Sparrow, and I've never heard of Marcus Bentley.
And you've no explanations for the cash withdrawals you made?
I told you, I haven't been to the bank. You know, either it's a mistake on your part or I'm the victim of identity theft. This is a waste of time.
Where were you between 10:53 and 12:37 two nights ago?
At home alone. I thought Kim was upstairs in bed, but as it turns out, she'd broken into the school, all of which you already know. Why would I steal anything from Becky? Our relationship ended 6 months ago.
For the benefit of the tape, I'm showing the suspect exhibit CB1. This is a printout of an email sent to Becky James from your daughter. Have you ever seen this email before, Dr. Patterson?
No.
Really? Because I think you have. You tried to stop Becky James from reading this email. And that is why you hired Marcus Bentley to steal her laptop, and that is why you deleted this email at 12:30 yesterday morning.
I don't have anyone's laptop.
Search my house.
Oh, we will. I'm pretty sure we won't find it. Because you needed it just long enough to get rid of this email. Why? What are you scared of?
My daughter is missing, Detective Inspector, so unless there's a point to all this...
You had him rattled there for a minute.
Yeah, but for what, though? He's clearly lying about the burglary. But his concern for Kim's welfare seems genuine.
He won't be manipulated into talking about the possibility of abuse without being arrested for it.
Mm.
And now he knows we don't have enough to do that.
No, not without Kim.
Been doing some cleaning?
And guess past you, does it?
What do you want? Jimmy. He's not at school.
He's helping a mate.
He thinks he is, but I'm not so sure. I know Jimmy thinks that I've interfered in your lives.
Mm.
That I shouldn't be trusted. This mate of his, she does need my help. People are worried. People have been hurt. It's got to stop. Jimmy? Jimmy, I know you're here. I just want to talk to you.
What did you say to him?
You didn't tell me the cops were involved.
So what if they are?
Listen, if you want me straight, I want you straight, yeah?
Jimmy! Jimmy, I know you're just looking out for her. You can't help her in the way she needs help.
I was just getting her some stuff.
Where is she, mate?
She's gonna hate me for this.
Still don't understand, Jimmy. She's back in school, somebody would have seen her. All the teachers have been told to look out for her.
And not all the classrooms are being used.
Jimmy.
Kim? Kim, Kim.
Leave me alone. Leave me alone. I don't need your help, okay?
On the advice of my solicitor, I'd like to read this prepared statement. 2 nights ago, I hired Marcus Bentley to break into Becky James's flat to steal her laptop. I'd like to make it clear that I never intended any harm to come to Becky James. However, I must acknowledge that it was my actions that led to Ms. James being injured, and I wish to extend my deepest apologies to her. My motive for all this was simply I wanted to protect my daughter. Protect her from Ms. James's interference in our lives. Since I ended our relationship, Ms. James has sought to undermine my relationship with my daughter. Kim is a very vulnerable girl who is still grieving from the death of her mother. What I did for my daughter. I would now like this matter to be dealt with so that Kim and I can resume our lives together.
Interview terminated, 13:53.
Where's Kim?
Millie's taken her to the soft interview room.
We've got no choice. We have to interview her now, find out where we stand.
She's a mess. She's not ready for that.
I'm afraid she's going to have to be, Nate.
Patterson's confessed. Can't we charge him with conspiracy? Detain him? Get social services in and give Kim the professional help she needs? Build a case for abuse?
Not as simple as that. Not anymore.
By making a statement, it's highly likely that Patterson will be bailed to appear. He's no flight risk. He's committed no actual act of violence himself. And he's also the primary carer of a minor. So unless Kim talks, she's going to be going home with her father tonight. You have a relationship with her, don't you? I want you there when we talk to her. Do you recognise this email? You wrote it? Your father's admitted that he had Becky James's flat broken into. He wanted to make sure that she never read this email. Do you know why he did that?
Becky was trying to help you, wasn't she? Do you think you can tell us why?
He wanted to protect me, to protect us. I should never have written that email.
What happened to Becky, Kim, was not your fault. Do you understand?
Isn't it? None of this would ever have happened if it wasn't for me.
You don't have to be scared of him.
He's not a monster, he's my father. You don't understand. You can't take him away, not him as well. I've got nothing to say to you, okay? Nothing, so just leave us alone.
She's protecting him.
Yeah, but if he's been hurting her, why won't she talk to us?
Because she loves him. She lost her mum. She lost the only teacher she was close to. She loses her dad. She's lost the only thing she has left.
Yeah, but if he's been abusing her...
Might not have got that far. Whatever's going on between father and daughter might not have manifested itself sexually.
Covert abuse.
Covert?
It's a form of emotional, psychological abuse where the parent imposes an emotionally and sexually codependent relationship on the child. It's still an abuse, but rather than an abuse of power, it's an abuse of love, where the parent and child are utterly dependent on each other.
That's almost exactly the way Becky described the relationship.
Well, we need to form an effective interview strategy, and we just don't know enough about Kim.
Excuse me.
Where are you going?
Speak to somebody on Kim's wavelength.
It's Kim's. I thought someone should collect it all up, just in case she needs it. Has she forgiven me yet?
I'm sure she will, mate.
It's just she seems so sad, you know?
Did Kim ever talk to you about why she was so sad?
Sort of. She doesn't like to talk that much. Her mum died. I think that affected her dad pretty badly. She's funny about him, though. She loves him, but at the same time, she doesn't. Almost like she's burdened by him. Like he drags her down.
How do you mean? Just trying to understand me.
I think he hurts her.
Hurts her? How?
Not like hitting or anything. I think he hurts her up here.
What makes you think that? Did Kim ever say something to you?
Not exactly.
Jimmy, I need you to help me get through to her.
She told me she likes to paint what she feels. Like that painting I did of my mum. She showed me how.
These are hers?
Yeah, they're pretty tame compared to the ones she showed me the other night.
When you broke in here? What were those like?
They weren't right. Up here, they weren't right.
Are those pictures still here?
No.
There's nothing in her room, and nothing in her father's.
You think she might have destroyed them?
I think it's possible.
I don't think so. She felt the need to create them. I don't think she'd be able to get rid of them just like that. Hide them, yeah, but not destroy them.
Where would she hide them, though?
It's got to be here. It's where it all started.
Here.
Unfortunately, this still isn't something we can take to the CPS.
No, but we can use them in an interview. Kim Patterson's been trying to tell us something. It's time we prove to her someone's listening.
Where did you get this?
I'm one of your mum's paintings.
You want.
Just don't want to give up on you, Kim. It's okay to be angry. You have every right.
What makes you think I'm angry?
These.
It's not what people think. It's James and Miss Rogers. Questions they asked me, I'm not dumb. I knew what they were getting at. But it's not like that.
He's your father. He loves you.
I want to help him, you know. He gets jealous. It's not right. It's not how we should feel, you know. I'm not sure I know what he needs.
You shouldn't have to, Kim.
He gets on my bed sometimes. On top of the covers. I'm scared. Not about now, about later. What he might do.
Be all right.
Is Kim okay? Can I see her?
Russell Patterson, I'm arresting you on suspicion of abuse. Do not have to say anything, but it may harm your defense if you do not mention when questioned something which you later rely on in court. Anything you do say may be given in evidence.
Where's Kim? Where is she? I need to speak to her.
I'm afraid that's not going to be possible, Dr. Patterson.
No! Don't you dare! Don't you dare take her away from me!
Calm down!
You have no right!
Please, Dr. Patterson, just calm down.
You must understand that I'd never hurt her. I love her.
She loves you too. But she's scared of you.
Should she be scared of you, Russell?
I don't know. You know, I tried with Becky. I really tried. I know I need help, but I wanted her to help me.
How could she help you?
I wanted her to show me how to feel what I was supposed to feel. But she wasn't Sarah. When I look at Kim, all I see is Sarah. I need help. Please. Please, please help me. I can't lose her. Not again.
You're right.
I feel sorry for him. Does that make sense?
It's easier when the bad guys are just plain bad. You did well.
Did I? Yeah. Where's the result?
Most people would have given up on Kim. On Russell, too. You helped two people today. Gave them another chance.
What are you doing here?
Relax. School's out. I was just going to see if she's all right.
She should be fine.
Is she ever going to see her dad again?
Maybe. If she can forgive him. If he can forgive himself. She'll stay with her grandmother while he gets the help he needs. Listen, I'm passing by your foster parents if you need a lift.
Yeah, all right, yeah. Are you going to see Miss James?
Maybe.
Don't mess her about. She deserves better.
Well, thanks for letting me know about Kim. Has anything happened?
No. I just wanted to bring you a farewell gift.
Oh, I forgot. It's your last day tomorrow.
Yeah. I thought I'd bring you something for you to remember me by.
Thank you. I'm touched, I think. Well, there are a few boxes of these hanging around the janitor's room somewhere.
Well, at least now you'll have always have a friendly face around, eh?
It is the best you can do.
Why?
I guess I kind of got used to the real thing.
Be nice.
Next time, right. On The Bill.
So I hear we only have the pleasure of Sergeant Diane Noble for one night, is that right?
Kerrigan!
Sonia!
Brendan, please, come away from there.